If you like this video, why not subscribe? Hey everybody, welcome back to the show. Today I'm going to do something a little bit different. I'm going to break away from the standard project-based or technique-based episode and talk specifically about the episode and how I put it together. I've had a lot of emails from people asking me all kinds of questions, from what kind of camera do you use, what's your microphone, how do you get your ideas, what editor do you use, how do you get your video on YouTube, and what are your settings to make it look so good. So today I'm going to answer all of those questions in an episode I like to call Episode Workflow. Now, before I make a show of any kind, I have to have a basic idea about what the show is going to be about. Now, you notice a lot of these shows are gear-related or technique-related most of the time, but there are three basic ways where I come up with my ideas. The first way is necessity. I need a piece of gear, I need to do a certain kind of shot or perform some certain kind of on-camera technique, and so I create that piece of gear or rig or technique to help me with that shot. Things like the PVC stabilizer rig, the PVC light stand, the dry erase slate, all came from a need that I had to do something specific on camera, and so I went ahead and created those things. The second way is suggestions from you, the viewer. I've had a lot of really good suggestions about ideas I never would have thought of or wanted to attempt, but I went ahead and attempted them anyway because you guys wanted to see it. I don't have a show without the viewers, so I need to do these things when you guys ask me to. Things like the frugal crane, the trolley dolly, and the DIY boom pole are all based on suggestions or requests that you had and you asked me to build, which is great. Hope you keep them coming. It's a little more challenging for me because I usually don't have a preconceived way of doing these things. I haven't formulated them out, so I have to seek out a way to do them, and that's where the end result comes from. And finally, there's just things that I think would be cool to build or cool to make or techniques I'd want to see. Things like the table dolly, the mini stabilizer, the lighting dimmer, the slow motion technique. All those things come from things that I would just want to see. I don't necessarily need them, no one asked me to do it, but I thought it would just be neat. So that's where those come from. Now all of these things, of course, take a little research and development. I can't just slap them on screen. All the things that I make have to fit into follow three basic rules. It has to be as simple as possible, it has to be as inexpensive as possible, and it has to work. Something else I think is really important with each build is it needs to be aesthetically pleasing. It needs to be pleasing to the eye. I want to be able to take any of these things out on shoots, and people might realize they're DIY, but at least they look good, or I hope they look good. That's really important to me, so I try to incorporate that into each design. Okay, so once it's time to shoot, I pull out my trusty handy-dandy video camera. This is the Canon Vixia HFS100. It's an HD camcorder with some prosumer features. Like, it does things like zebra stripes, which is pretty cool. It tells you when you're overexposing. It's also got manual audio control, it's got a mic input, it's got a headphone jack, all the basic things you really need in a camera. Oh, and it has a lens, that's important too. This is a good camera, it came out right before the DSLR rage exploded, so that's the one I ended up with, and I'm going to hold on to it until it dies, basically. But when I take this camera and I shoot my video, I shoot it full bit rate, which is 24 kilobits per second, and maximum resolution, which is full HD, 1920 by 1080. Now you may look at my videos and notice that on YouTube they only go up to 720p, so you might ask, why am I shooting at full HD? Well, that's because I want the option to be able to crop the frame at any time and not lose resolution when I go uploading. So I shoot as maximum as I can, and that way I'll have that wiggle room in post if I do need to crop the frame. I think that's really important. My B camera is the Sanyo Exacti CG10, also a camera you can't find anymore. It's been replaced by the CG20. But it's a decent little entry-level camera. It's got a lot of manual features on it, which is really good, but the image in no way holds up to the Canon, but it's good for web video. Many of you have asked me what this black box is that I keep attaching to my camera. This is what I call an Xlr box, or an Xlr interface. It allows you to use Xlr mics with a standard 1/8 inch input on your camera. This is the Xlr Pro from Signed Video. It costs about $150. And essentially, it's a passive mixer. It's an interface that allows you to use more expensive microphones with your less expensive microphone connections. I use it when I use a shotgun mic when I go on shoots, but I never use a shotgun mic on this show, so you hardly ever see a shotgun mic. But it's very handy. It's probably unnecessary now, since one of the great uses of this box was to block the 3 volts that came out of a camera's mic input in the past. These mic inputs will be used to power inexpensive microphones, but now even inexpensive microphones have their own power supply, so it's really not necessary. You could probably get away with just using a standard XLR to 1/8 inch cord. You can get them for about $8 on Amazon. So this whole box is probably unnecessary, but I still have it. It still works well, so I still use it. Now the tripod I use is a Bogan 501 fluid head attached to Manfrotto 3046 sticks. And you'll see this tripod pop up in a lot of videos. It's been pretty good for supporting my crane and the trolley dolly because it's pretty beefy, it's pretty heavy duty. As a result, it's really heavy also. So I wish I had a lighter duty tripod, but this is the one I use. This is my tripod that I use all the time. It's a good tripod. The fluid head is great for pans and tilts. It's super smooth, so I really like it. Not very frugal. It was around $300 when I bought it, but it still lasted a long time. It's just a good solid tripod. Now I've basically got three locations that I use for every video. I've got my living room, my kitchen, and then right outside my door. The living room is used for all the intros and outros that you'll see in every episode. I just take my camera and my three-point lighting and set it up in my living room. I already made several videos about that, but that's where all those are shot. When I go to actually build something, I'll move into my kitchen, where I'll bounce two 500 watt work lights off the ceiling and illuminate my kitchen table, and that's where I'll build every project you've ever seen on this show is usually assembled on that kitchen table. Then when I want to shoot some test footage, I'll go outside and I'll do whatever I have to do out there. It usually there's a decent variety of locations. There's grass, there's buildings, there's trees. You've probably all seen it and looks very familiar. So that's where I get that footage. Now if I want to do any screen captures, I use Camstudio, which is a free open source program. I'll put a link to it in the description. That allows me to capture the entire screen and follow whatever I'm doing. Actually, it doesn't follow, it's just kind of a wide shot. But the videos I post, I do have cuts in them. I do cut the closer shots, and what I'm doing there is I'm just taking the whole screen and I'm zooming in with Vegas's pan crop tool, and I'm just cutting right to that. You'll notice there is no zooming in and out like a lot of screen capture programs do, which admittedly would be easier, but I like to edit it in post so it gives it more of an edited feel, opposed to that zoomy feel, which I don't really like. For a couple videos, I've actually captured information that was on my LCD screen on my camera along with the picture, and some people have wondered how I did that. What I did was I ran the composite outs from my camera into an analog to digital video converter. This is the Canopus ADVC-100. It's a pretty handy little box. I run my analog ins right into it, and then it's got a firewire out that I then connect into my computer and use my video capture program in Vegas to capture live video, and it works just perfectly. Now, I don't know if these boxes are even available anymore, but that's what I use. Now, when I do voiceover work for the show, I record into the Zoom H1 handy recorder. It's a good digital recorder, and I use the Radio Shack omnidirectional tie clip microphone, model 33-3013. This is the same microphone that I'm wearing anytime you see me on camera. It's what I use all the time. It's inexpensive, in fact, and so useful that I created an entire episode about it. And if you click on the annotation, it'll go right to the episode, and you can find out all you want about this nice, inexpensive, decent microphone. My editor of choice for all this material is Sony Vegas Pro 10. Version 9 is probably more stable, but I like 10. It allows you to add individual audio effects to specific clips. None of the previous versions allowed that. But it's a really solid editor. I've been using it for years. Started off as an audio editor, so it has a lot of strong audio tools, which a lot of editors seem to ignore, but not Vegas. It has a lot of great things going for it, so I use it all the time for everything. Now, a lot of people have wondered how I make my video look so good and what my export settings are. Well, thank you if you think it looks good. I'm always trying to make it look better. But here's the settings that I use. When I click on the export or render as button in Vegas, I save as type main concept AVC/AAC, which is essentially an MP4. Then click on your custom button and put your settings as follows. Have a custom frame size. Since I'm uploading at 720p, and my width is 1280, my height is 720. The profile is main, the frame rate is 29.970, standard NTSC. The field order is none because we're shooting in progressive scan. The variable bit rate is turned on, and the maximum BPS or bits per second is 16 million. Average is 8 million. And that's pretty much it. Audio is pretty standard. It's 48 kilohertz, 192 kilobits per second. And project tab, the video rendering quality is set to best. And that's basically it. I got all these settings from Eugenia's Rants and Thoughts blog, which you can find the direct link to where I got my information from in the description. And the rest is more or less about marketing. I take my rendered file and I upload it to YouTube. I annotate it if necessary. I then take that file, get the embed code, create a post on my blog. When the blog post is done, I take that link and I send it to Twitter and I post it on Facebook. And that pretty much is it. And that's basically how I do an episode. Now, all these ideas for you, of course, are just suggestions. You can take all these ideas, twist them, turn them, inflate them, shrink them, make them better, insert them into your own shows, use them as good ideas, and then share what you learn back with me or and everybody else. Excuse me, right now I'm going to get back to watching internet content on my TV, Wave of the Future and all. See you next time. And so today I'm going to answer all of those questions, if I can speak and finish any sentences without, you know, garbling them or sounding ridiculous. So let's try that.